Hey there, viewers. Kidney stones are extremely painful. A high concentration of minerals like calcium, oxalate, and uric acid form a type of crystal. These crystals stick together to form kidney stones. In short, when your urine doesn't have enough fluid, kidney stones will happen. In today's video, we'll be discussing why this happens. How is a lack of water responsible for kidney stones? What role does your diet play in this? Should you increase or decrease your intake of animal protein? We'll be discussing all of these and more. Number 1. Lack of water. One of the most common reasons behind kidney stones is a lack of water in your body. It's important for you to drink a lot of water in order to pee frequently. If you don't drink enough water, there won't be enough fluid in your kidney to dissolve substances that form crystals. Without that dilution, stones will be formed in your kidneys. It's recommended you drink at least 10 cups of water a day. Considering you lose a bit of fluid through sweat, you still have enough in your kidney to ensure you urinate about 8 cups a day. If possible, you can swap a glass of water with a citrus drink like lemonade or orange. This helps as the citrate stops stones from forming. Do you drink enough water throughout the day? Do you keep yourself hydrated? Share your preferences with the Bestie community in the comments below. Number 2. Diet. It's not just about fluids. The risk of kidney stones increases based on the kinds of foods you eat. One of the most common forms of kidney stones occurs when the calcium and oxalate in your body stick together during urination. Considering that oxalate is present in most of the healthy foods you eat, it's not easy to get rid of. But if you've had a kidney stone in the past, it's best to avoid high oxalate foods like spinach, bran cereal, and rhubarb. There is a tendency to avoid calcium-rich foods like milk and cheese. Instead, if you have foods with calcium and oxalate at the same time, you lessen the risk. This is because the calcium and oxalate combine in your gut rather than your kidneys, making stone formation less likely. Number 3. Sodium. If you consume way too much table salt, you run the risk for many different types of kidney stones. This is because the sodium ends up increasing the amount of calcium in your urine. Snacks like fries and chips are loaded with these salts. The same with canned foods. These types of foods are the primary reason behind sodium-related kidney stones. You should also try to avoid packaged meats and other processed foods. By doing this, you avoid the associated issues with blood pressure and heart disease. Looking for answers on all the latest health and wellness news? Hit that subscribe button and join our millions of followers. Stay up to date on all of our great Bestie content. Number 4. Animal protein. Another type of kidney stone you get is when your pee becomes acidic. This happens when you eat too much red meat or shellfish. These foods with animal proteins tend to raise the uric acid in your body. This either collects in your joints or causes gout. If it's not those things, the uric acid could end up in your kidneys, causing stones. The animal protein you eat also increases the calcium level in your urine. It brings down the citrate levels in your body. The combination ends up causing kidney stones. Number 5. Gut problems. If you have inflammatory bowel disease such as Crohn's or ulcerative colitis, your chances of suffering kidney stones are greater than before. Bowel problems, like diarrhea, cause you to pee a lot less than normal. Your body also ends up absorbing the additional oxalate from your intestines, which means more of it gets into your urine. You don't have to worry about every bout of diarrhea. It doesn't always cause these problems. Your chances of getting kidney stones are only higher if it's a chronic case. Number 6. Obesity. If you're obese, you'll likely get kidney stones. Obesity is when your body mass index, or BMI, goes above 30. Once this happens, you'll need to start cutting back on fat. If you choose to go for weight loss surgery, you might have problems absorbing nutrients. Now, this doesn't always happen, but people who get gastric bypass surgery are at a much higher risk of ending up with kidney stones. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like. Watch and learn more about the 7 ways to naturally boost your immune system. Now back to our discussion on the cause of kidney stones. Number 7. Genetic diseases. Sometimes a person is predisposed to kidney stones because of their genetic makeup. Certain genetic diseases can cause cysts to form in your kidneys. This is a birth defect that often causes the formation of kidney stones. Number 8. Type 2 diabetes. If you're suffering from type 2 diabetes, your chances of getting kidney stones is more than double. If you use insulin to treat the condition, it actually ends up increasing your chances even more. The reason behind this is that diabetes makes your urine more acidic. As I said earlier, more acidic urine means you end up with stone formation in your kidneys. If your cells develop insulin resistance due to diabetes, it increases the calcium content in your urine. Also, high levels of insulin means more acidity. All of these factors combine to make kidney stones a much more likely outcome for those with type 2 diabetes. Number 9. Gout. If you're suffering from gout, you're more likely to get kidney stones. This is because the crystals that cause gout can also form painful stones in your kidneys. Since gout develops from high uric acid and the acid is filtered through your kidneys, the two conditions are related. When your kidneys don't filter out waste, the extra uric acid can form into crystals. If your body doesn't respond to the medication you take, it causes complications for your kidneys and results in more stones. Number 10. Hyperparathyroidism. I know, big word, right? One of the more common reasons for kidney stones is hyperparathyroidism. In fact, if you end up with kidney stones, your doctor would probably test you for problems with your parathyroid glands. About half the people with kidney stones test positive for a parathyroid tumor. When there's an issue with your parathyroid glands, they could end up sending out more hormones than necessary. This results in higher levels of calcium in your blood, as well as your urine. The elevated calcium levels cause kidney stones. Number 11. Renal tubular acidosis. All right, one more difficult name to get through. If you're suffering from renal tubular acidosis, you'll have an imbalance in your body's electrolytes. The condition will cause increased calcium deposits in your kidneys. As a result, you end up developing kidney stones. Number 12. Medications. Some medications you're taking will unintentionally cause kidney stones. This includes antibiotics. If you're being treated for HIV or AIDS, some of the meds cause kidney stones to take effect. For those suffering from high blood pressure, certain diuretics are prescribed. These medicines can end up giving you kidney stones. Not all diuretics are bad, though. Certain meds can actually lead to your kidney stones being broken up. Kidney stones are painful and pose a huge health risk. They cause inflammation to take place, and if the problem isn't addressed in time, it only leads to other health problems down the road. However, there are things you can do to make sure your kidneys are healthy. How's your diet been lately? Let's take a look at a couple more videos. Check out 13 foods that make your kidneys healthy. You can also try 4 ways to do a natural kidney cleanse at home. Go ahead and click one, or better yet, watch both, and learn more about how to keep your kidneys from suffering. Have you ever had kidney stones? Let us know in the comments below.